गुड मॉर्निंग बेटा. इन द लास्ट क्लास हमने स्टार्ट किया था इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशंस इन बेंजीन, राइट? एंड आई हैव एक्सप्लेन्ड क्लोरीनेशन दैट इज अ पार्ट ऑफ हैलोजिनेशन. इलेक्ट्रोफिलिक सब्स्टिट्यूशंस मीन्स इलेक्ट्रोफाइल इज गोइंग टू अटैक ऑन बेंजीन. Now when we see halogenation, so halogenation means it's going to be fluorine, chlorine, bromine and iodine that can attack on benzene. Order of reactivity, fluorine is more reactive, then chlorine, then bromine, then iodine. So this is order of reactivity. It means fluorine is very reactive as compared to chlorine, bromine, and then iodine. When we see benzene react with fluorine in presence of this iron, Lewis acid, these two are going to give us fluorobenzene plus HF, but this reaction is very explosive. Fluorobenzene is not prepared by this method from benzene because of explosive nature of this reaction. As this reaction is explosive, fluorobenzene is not prepared by benzene plus fluorine. Chlorination we have done. It is Cl2 plus FeCl3 and benzene. We get chlorobenzene plus HCl. Here the attacking electrophile is Cl positive. जो इलेक्ट्रोफाइल यहाँ अटैक करेगा बेंजीन पे, वो लास्ट क्लास में जब आपने मैकेनिज्म किया था तो वी गॉट दिस सीएल पॉजिटिव एज इंटरमीडिएट. दिस सीएल पॉजिटिव इज गोइंग टू अटैक ऑन बेंजीन. इन केस ऑफ ब्रोमिनेशन द अटैकिंग इलेक्ट्रोफाइल इज बीआर पॉजिटिव. बीआर पॉजिटिव अटैक ऑन बेंजीन एंड दिस बीआर पॉजिटिव इज गोइंग टू गिव अस ब्रोमोबेंजीन. ड्यूरिंग आयोडिनेशन when nitric acid, HiO3, these two are added, we get formation of iodobenzene plus Hi, and we can say that iodination is a reversible reaction. Therefore, Hi is going to be, basically it's a reversible reaction and slow. It's a slow reaction because Hi is a strong reducing agent, and this Hi is going to make the equation backward. Reaction will become backward. Thus, HNO3 or HiO3, these two oxidizing agents are added to remove this Hi. Now, Hi is removed so that equilibrium shifts forward. So just to make this equilibrium forward, we remove this Hi. So this is about your halogenation. I'll repeat, four type of halogenation: fluorination, chlorination, bromination and iodination. Out of this, fluorination is explosive, chlorination is normal speed, controllable, we can conduct this reaction. Bromination is okay, very fine, good reaction. But iodination is reversible because Hi is a strong reducing agent, is a slow reaction. Therefore, nitric acid or HiO3, these two are added to remove Hi so that equilibrium shift forward. This is about your halogenation. Now we'll start with Friedel-Crafts reaction. Second important electrophilic substitution is Friedel-Crafts reaction. When we say Friedel-Crafts reaction, the Friedel-Crafts reaction is a reaction of benzene with alkyl halide and acyl halide in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. This is a very important reagent without which we can't think of Friedel-Crafts reactions. The Friedel-Crafts reaction, it is reaction of benzene with alkyl halide and acyl halide in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. In this reaction, carbonium ion, which is the attacking reagent or attacking electrophile, yahan jo benzene pe attack karega, that will be carbonium ion. Now we can say carbonium ion, it means carbon positive. Now we'll start with this mechanism of Friedel-Graf reaction. Now, Friedel-Graf reactions, it's going to be of two types, Friedel-Graf reaction. One category we can discuss as alkylation, that is named as Friedel-Graf alkylation. And second we can say that it is Friedel-Graf acylation. First attempt is benzene plus RCl. RCl is alkyl halide. In presence of anhydrous AlCl3, which is the catalyst out here, this AlCl3 must be anhydrous. We get formation of alkyl benzene plus HCl. And in case of acylation, it is benzene plus RCOCl in presence of again anhydrous AlCl3. We get formation of aromatic ketones COR on benzene plus HCl. The acylation is with RCOCl and alkylation is with RCl. These are the two types of Friedel-Graf discussions. Now first we'll start with Friedel-Graf alkylation. The first is Friedel-Graf alkylation and its mechanism. When we say mechanism of Friedel-Graf alkylation, the step one, AlCl3 being covalent and Lewis acid, as it is a Lewis acid, it react with RCl and we get formation of AlCl4- plus R positive. The first step here is alkyl halide. It's going to be reacted with AlCl3 leading to the formation of AlCl4- and R positive. Now as it is a carbocation which is formed over here, so this is going to be a carbocation. So R positive is carbocation. Now this carbocation is now going to attack on benzene. Step 2 is benzene plus R positive. Now this pi bond will shift towards one direction, that is called electromeric shift, and R positive is going to be bonded over there. Now it is R cation and here it is H, because H is already there on benzene. This carbocation is resonance stabilized. As this carbocation is resonance stabilized, this is formed out here. The carbocation formed is stabilized by resonance. Resonance stabilized. That is your second step. The first step, alkylation, Friedel-Crafts alkylation. First step is formation of carbocation. Second step is Friedel-Crafts alkylation. We get cation attacking on benzene. Now step 3. Step 3 is this carbocation formed during the reaction is now going to give alkyl benzene plus H positive. This is step 3. And step 4 of the mechanism is H positive combined with AlCl4 negative, we get AlCl3 plus HCl. That is the final answer. This overall, it's going to be 4-step mechanism. One is electrophile formation, generation, that is first step. Second step is attack of electrophile on benzene. Third step, it is deprotonation, H positive is eliminated out. And fourth is your H positive react with AlCl4 negative, leading to the formation of AlCl3 and HCl. That's about your Friedel-Crafts reaction and its mechanism. Now we move on to important point here. Now carbocation formed can go for rearrangement. Can go for rearrangement. Now this point we have to discuss in detail. For example, let's start with the exemplification. The example of first reaction, that is first example, benzene plus CH3Cl in presence of anhydrous AlCl3. H and Cl removed, we get formation of toluene plus HCl. Cation formed, you must know that here is CH3 positive. The CH3 positive cation is formed. What is the first step? We will write first step of the mechanism. AlCl3 react with CH3Cl, we get AlCl4 negative plus Cl positive, as this is the electrophile formed CH3 positive, sorry. Now it is CH3 positive, and this is the first step by which we get formation of carbocation. The CH3 positive is formed over there. This is the AlCl3 plus CH3Cl leading to the formation of AlCl4 negative plus CH3 positive. Let's take some more examples of Friedel-Crafts reaction. Example 2. Benzene plus ethyl benzene, CH3CH2Cl, in presence of AlCl3, anhydrous AlCl3. Now we get formation of CH2CH3 on benzene plus HCl. we get ethyl benzene plus HCl. So what is the attacking electrophile out there? It is CH3CH2 positive. How it is formed? It is ethyl chloride plus AlCl3. We get CH3CH2 positive plus AlCl4 negative. That is the step one of mechanism. Now we move on to the third example. Example 3 is benzene plus propyl chloride, CH3CH2CH2Cl. Anhydrous AlCl3 is added to it. We get formation of product, which is surprisingly different, and this product is now CH3CH3, that is isopropylbenzene. This product is different than the expected product. Why it is formed over there? Reason for that is, when CH3CH2CH2Cl react with AlCl3, we get formation of CH3CH2CH2 positive plus AlCl4 negative. And this propyl cation, as it is not very stable carbocation, it's a primary carbocation. This primary carbocation go for hydride shift. And when hydride shift takes place, we get formation of CH3CH positive CH3, and this is the carbocation which is now going to attack on benzene. So carbocation rearrangement takes place, and this carbocation rearrangement is leading to the formation of isopropylbenzene, which is also named as cumene. Isopropylbenzene, also named as cumene. Common name of this compound is cumene. Now look at the third example once again. In this example, carbocation formed is primary carbocation, which is rearranged by hydride shift, leading to the formation of a secondary carbocation. And this secondary carbocation is going to give us a product, which is isopropylbenzene. Now if it is CH3CH2CH2CH2Cl, can you predict the product formed? Anhydrous AlCl3 we have added. Now which reaction is the first step and what will be the product formed? Think over it. It is butyl chloride combined with AlCl3 in presence of this benzene. What will be the final product? Now this butyl chloride, it is going to give us the first step of mechanism, CH3, CH2Cl plus AlCl3, and we get primary carbocation formed. And this primary carbocation is going to rearrange itself. And now this rearrangement of primary carbocation by hydride shift is leading to the formation of secondary carbocation. And this secondary carbocation will attack on benzene. It means in this reaction, we are going to get secondary butyl benzene. The product formed is secondary butyl benzene plus HCl. Now let's start with another example. If it is benzene plus 2-chlorobutane, in presence of AlCl3, what will be the product formed? Let's predict the product. Now in this reaction, we are having a secondary carbocation formed. Here is the Cl, and AlCl3 react with it. We get formation of a secondary carbocation. But now this secondary carbocation can go for this methide shift. And methide shift is leading to the formation of CH2, CH3, and here it is a positive charge. And another shift can make it a tertiary carbocation. This carbocation can rearrange to give us a tertiary carbocation. It means finally, we get formation of a tertiary butyl benzene from this reaction. Plus HCl. Let's change the reaction by changing one of the reactant. If this is the reactant, now sixth example, explain the product formed. Sixth example, benzene plus isobutyl chloride. If it is isobutyl chloride, what will be the product formed? Completed. Now mechanism and the first step. I have given you this example number 6. Now carbocation formed here is CH3, CH, CH3, CH2 positive, And this carbocation will go for hydride shift. And we get a tertiary carbocation. So we can get tertiary carbocation formed over here. This carbocation is now going to attack on benzene, and the product formed will be again tertiary butyl benzene. The tertiary butyl benzene plus HCl, that is the final product. Alkyl benzenes can be prepared by alcohols and alkenes in acidic medium with benzene. First example we have is, if it is benzene plus methanol, in presence of H positive, this water is removed and CH3 becomes positive, and this positive can go to benzene. So we get formation of toluene. It means methyl alcohol can give us toluene. Ethyl alcohol will give us ethyl benzene. Benzene plus CH3CH2OH, that is ethanol, in presence of H positive, it will be again water removed, carbocation formed, pi bond shift, and carbocation attack on benzene. In case of alkenes, for example, if there is CH2 double bond CH2, in presence of H positive, pi bond shift, here it is negative positive, pi bond shift, and this type of bonding will occur. It means finally we get formation of ethyl benzene. Because H positive from the medium is going to be there, this will be CH3, CH2 is positive, and this positive at benzene. Now, in case we have another example of alkene, like cyclohexene plus benzene, if it is benzene plus cyclohexene, again in presence of H positive, pi bond shift, H positive bonded to it, here it is positive charge, pi bond shift, and this is attacked by benzene. Now we get benzene attached to a cyclohexane. The cyclohexane will be attached to benzene if we have cyclohexane plus benzene. Friedel-Crafts reaction can be intramolecular also. 1 carbon, 2 carbon, 3 carbon and chlorine. If we have intramolecular Friedel-Crafts reaction with AlCl3, that is Cl removed by AlCl3, here it will be positive charge, and this positive charge can attack on benzene. The benzene will react with this positive charge. Cation and cation will form the bond. and we get benzene bonded to a 3-carbon ring. This is called intramolecular Friedel-Crafts. Intramolecular Friedel-Crafts. Let's see again. In case we have benzene plus CH2Cl2, the two benzene may react in presence of AlCl3. HCl removed, HCl removed, and we get formation of CH2 with 2-benzene. Now complete the reaction of chloroform with excess of benzene. Benzene plus CHCl3, that is chloroform, in presence of AlCl3. 3 moles benzene, because excess of benzene is added, it will react with chloroform. What will be the product formed? Complete the reaction of benzene with chloroform. Now what will be the product? Product formed is triphenyl methane plus 3-HCl. That's all about your Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Now we move on to limitations of Friedel-Crafts alkylations. Now, limitation of Friedel-Crafts alkylation. First limitation, this reaction cannot be used with Friedel-Crafts reaction. Not used with aryl halides and vinyl halides. What does it mean? It means when we have benzene plus CH2 double bond CHCl and AlCl3, not a promising product, because beta yahan par resonance is taking place, and due to resonance we are having a partial double bond character of chlorine with the chain. It's not possible to substitute this chlorine and then attack at benzene. Vinyl chloride has resonance, therefore a partial double bond character is there, and that partial double bond character is making it very stable. It cannot break easily. That's the first problem. Same way aryl halide. In case of chlorobenzene, when it is benzene plus chlorobenzene, in presence of AlCl3, and we want to have Friedel-Crafts reaction, not possible. Reason is chlorine is having partial double bond character, again because of resonance. chlorine is having resonance with benzene, due to which there is a partial double bond character in chlorobenzene also. So vinyl halide cannot go for this reaction. Chlorobenzene cannot go for this reaction. That is the first limitation. Second limitation, after one substitution, reaction cannot be stopped. Second limitation हमारी ये है, we can't stop this reaction after one substitution. That means, let us suppose this is the reaction and we get toluene, right? But this toluene will again react with another CH3ClAlCl3. As it is ortho para directing, we get 2 methyl group, that is either at ortho or at para, and so on. This reaction can continue till multiple substitution levels. So we get more than one substitution. We can't stop reaction after one substitution. Third limitation, phenol aniline react with AlCl3 directly, because this is a Lewis base and AlCl3 is a Lewis acid. The yield in Friedel-Crafts reaction will not be there properly with phenol and aniline. Same process take with place with AlCl3 also. So we can say again Lewis base, Lewis acid. So these are not willing to go give a proper yield with Friedel-Crafts processes. The Friedel-Crafts catalyst is being used with phenol and aniline. Thus, these compounds do not go for Friedel-Crafts reaction. Fourth limitation, deactivated benzene ring do not prefer Friedel-Crafts reaction. Friedel-Crafts reactions like nitrobenzene, benzoic acid, these are deactivated. Benzonitrile deactivated, then benzoic acid. Deactivity means these are having electron withdrawal nature by resonance. Nitro is having negative resonance, cyanide negative resonance, benzoic acid negative resonance. They are taking negative M effect or negative resonance effect. Due to mesomeric effect or this resonance effect, we are having a electron withdrawing group attached to benzene. They are not going for any Friedel-Crafts process. And fifth limitation of this reaction is, we can't get linear alkyl product always. Linear alkyl substitutions do not take place. Carbocation rearrangement take place. So carbocation rearrange. When rearrangement of carbocation is there, we get branched products. These are the five limitations of Friedel-Crafts reaction. First limitation, first limitation we have is we can't use it for chlorobenzene and vinyl chloride because of double bond character. Ketine is not possible. Second limitation, after one substitution, we can't stop the reaction. Any multiple substituted products are formed. Third limitation, phenol and aniline, those are with lone pair. The groups having lone pair on them are not willing to go for Friedel-Crafts reaction because they react with the catalyst itself. Fourth limitation, nitrocyanoacids. These will not go for Friedel-Crafts reaction because they are highly deactivated. And last is, carbocation rearrangement always give us multiple substituted products. You can say branched products are formed. That's the problem, right? So this is about your electrophilic substitution, Friedel-Crafts alkylation we are finished with. Now we move on to Friedel-Crafts acylation. The next topic we'll start is Friedel-Crafts acylation. Now, Friedel-Crafts acylation. Friedel-Crafts acylation is benzene plus RCOCl in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, and we get formation of COR on benzene plus HCl. This is called Friedel-Crafts acylation. Step 1 of the mechanism is RCOCl plus AlCl3. We get RCO positive cation plus AlCl4 negative. This is the step 1 for this mechanism. Now this carbocation is stable because of resonance. We can see this carbocation is stabilized by lone pair of this oxygen, positive charge, double bond and so on. So we can see this Friedel-Crafts acylation is having faster speed as compared to alkylation. The better in this reaction is Friedel-Crafts acylation is taking place without any rearrangement. One limitation is removed. Another limitation is removed. If there is no rearrangement, the another part is once Friedel-Crafts acylation takes place, multiple acylation will not take place. Yani bar bar benzene jo hai iske saath react nahi karega. Only one time reaction will be there. That is the benefit of your Friedel-Crafts acylation. Right? The Friedel-Crafts acylation is going to be better, faster, one product giving, no carbocation rearrangement. These are the benefits of Friedel-Crafts acylation. Single product, one achievement. No rearrangement, which is another achievement. And comparatively fast and better. The Friedel-Crafts acylation is a better way, better reaction as compared to Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Complete example of Friedel-Crafts acylation. Let's complete the reaction. Take this example, benzene plus CH3COCl. In presence of AlCl3, anhydrous AlCl3. Complete this reaction. With this, we have finished with Friedel-Crafts processes, Friedel-Crafts reactions of benzene. The one topic we have finished with Friedel-Crafts reactions. What is the product formed here? COCH3 on benzene. This is commonly named as acetophenone. we get formation of acetophenone. This acetophenone, if is reduced, zinc amalgam and HCl, so we can get ethylbenzene. Reduction can give us ethylbenzene. It means by making ketone first and then reducing the product, we can get alkyl group. Complete this one more reaction by which we can get propylbenzene. CH3, CH2, CH2Cl plus AlCl3, no rearrangement is there now. COCl, propanoyl chloride. We get formation of propylbenzene. COCH3. And this is now reduced with zinc amalgam to give us propylbenzene. Otherwise, propylbenzene we can't prepare. Propylbenzene can be prepared by this reaction because this carbonyl can be reduced. Isko reduction karenge to kya ban jayega? Propylbenzene. Direct propylbenzene Friedel-Crafts alkylation cannot give us. That's the problem with the Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Benzene plus C double bond O Cl and another benzene if is added to it in presence of AlCl3, we get formation of benzoquinone diphenyl methanol. So this reaction is again Friedel-Crafts acylation. Benzophenone is the name. This is named as benzophenone. So we are finished with Friedel-Crafts acylation also. One more topic, acylation is finished. The next topic is nitration of benzene. Next heading we have is nitration of benzene. Now Friedel-Crafts reactions are finished. Nitration of benzene. Here benzene react with HONO2, nitric acid. In presence of sulfuric acid, we get formation of nitrobenzene plus water. Product formed is nitrobenzene plus water. Here the attacking electrophile is HONO2 plus sulfuric acid. These two react with each other to give us NO2 positive plus HSO4 negative plus water. So electrophile generated by the reaction of nitric acid with sulfuric acid. Here nitric acid is acting as a base and sulfuric acid is acting as acid because it is giving proton, it is H positive donor. And nitric acid is proton acceptor. Important question. During nitration, nitric acid is acting as. The answer is not acid. It's acting as a base. So nitration, during nitration, we get nitro group attached on benzene. Nitronium ion is formed during the process. And we get the answer, nitro product. Important here is NO2 positive is the electrophile that is produced by the reaction between sulfuric acid and nitric acid. Now nitration, if we have benzene and nitric acid HONO2 in presence of sulfuric acid, so we get nitrobenzene. But if same reaction is conducted at 100 degrees Celsius, we get dinitrobenzene and nitro group is at meta directing because this nitro is meta-directing, we get meta-nitro product. And if more than 100 degrees given, same reaction, we get trinitro derivative, then we have meta-nitro at three position, nitro positions at two meta positions, trinitrobenzene is formed. The sulfuric acid react with nitric acid to give us NO2 positive. NO2 positive is going to give us nitrobenzene finally. This is about nitration of benzene. We are finished with the topic nitration of benzene. Next we have is sulfonation of benzene. Sulfonation of benzene is benzene react with sulfuric acid. The next topic after nitration is sulfonation. Sulfonation of benzene is benzene plus sulfuric acid HOSO3H. We get formation of benzene sulfonic acid plus water. That is sulfonation. Sulfuric acid used here is a concentrated sulfuric acid. That means having SO3, which is electrophile. The electrophile during sulfonation is SO3. The SO3 is the electrophile. It is a neutral electrophile during the process. Till now, this is the first electrophile we have used with benzene. And this electrophile is electrophile because of its pi electron cloud around it. One bond is shifted, sulfur positive, and this positively charged sulfur is being attacked by benzene. So during sulfonation, SO3 is the electrophile, which is a neutral electrophile during the process. Otherwise, we have carbocations, cations as electrophiles. That is the process of sulfonation. Now, fifth reaction, it is Getterman-Koch reaction. Next is Getterman-Koch reaction. Now Getterman-Koch reaction, it's a reaction of benzene with carbon monoxide and HCl in presence of anhydrous zinc chloride. These two are going to react and we get HCOCl, carbon monoxide plus HCl, we get formation of HCOCl, and now this Cl is removed and we get formation of benzaldehyde. The Getterman-Koch reaction is leading to benzaldehyde formation. It is Getterman-Koch reaction. A reaction in which carbon monoxide and HCl react with benzene in presence of anhydrous AlCl3, we get formation of benzaldehyde. Here the active electrophile is HCO positive. And if this H is starred H, this H is traveling with it, it means benzaldehyde will have the hydrogen from HCl. This H will not be there on benzaldehyde. It is the H positive from acid going to be on benzene. 6 is ketraman aldehyde synthesis. Ketraman aldehyde synthesis. Ketraman aldehyde synthesis is again a reaction of benzene with HCN and HCl in presence of anhydrous zinc chloride. These two will react together to give us HC double bond N ClH. Chloroaldehamine, this is formed. Now Cl is removed, H is removed. We get formation of benzene substituted with CH double bond NH, which is hydrolyzed. Water is added to it in presence of acid and we get formation of benzaldehyde. To get Ketraman aldehyde synthesis, first we get CH double bond NH on benzene. This is removed. This NH will go and we get oxygen here with water. So we get benzaldehyde formed at the last. This NH is removed and we get benzaldehyde. So this is about your Ketraman aldehyde synthesis. With this we are finished with important electrophilic substitution reactions in benzene. So substitutions in benzene, these are all electrophilic. Positive species are attacking on benzene. Now let's sum up the topic, electrophilic substitution in benzene. Ketraman COH synthesis, Ketraman aldehyde synthesis, both are for the same benzaldehyde preparation. Let's make a flowchart of all these reactions so that we can learn these reactions. It is benzene in the middle. First, chlorine in presence of FeCl3. Then bromine with FeBr3. CH3Cl with AlCl3. CH3CH2CH2Cl with AlCl3. RCOCl with AlCl3, Friedel-Crafts acylation. Nitric acid in presence of sulfuric acid. Only sulfuric acid concentrated. CO and HCl, Ketraman COH synthesis. HCN plus HCN, Ketraman aldehyde synthesis. This is nitration, sulfonation, Ketraman aldehyde, Ketraman COH synthesis. And this is Ketraman aldehyde synthesis. Bromination, Friedel-Crafts alkylation, Friedel-Crafts acylation. These are the important reactions. This is again Friedel-Crafts alkylation. So these are the reactions, those are there with benzene, and all these are electrophilic substitution. In first case chlorination, we get chlorobenzene. In bromination, we get bromobenzene. With methyl benzene, it is toluene formed. With propyl benzene, carbocation rearrangement takes place. Therefore, we get cumene. Acylation, no carbocation rearrangement. Therefore, direct acylated product. During nitration, we get nitrobenzene. During sulfonation, it is benzene sulfonic acid. Getterman-Koch synthesis, we get benzaldehyde. In Getterman-aldehyde synthesis, it's again benzaldehyde. These reactions and their products must be remembered by you. Now, attacking electrophile in all these reactions, Cl positive in chlorination, Br positive in bromination, CH3 positive in Friedel-Crafts alkylation, isopropyl cation, rearranged cation in the Friedel-Crafts alkylation, the next one, RC double bond O positive in acylation, NO2 positive in nitration. During sulfonation, SO3, which is a neutral electrophile. Here it is HC double bond O positive, that is the electrophile. Here it is HC double bond NH positive is the electrophile during the reaction. These are the electrophiles in various reactions. So you must remember the reaction chart, how many reactions, how do these reactions are taking place, what are the limitations of Friedel-Crafts reactions, what are the final products, what are the achievements of Friedel-Crafts acylation. All these are important reactions. Electrophilic substitutions we are finished with. So we are finished with the benzene and its compounds, aromatic compounds finished. Overall, when organic chemistry of plus one class is finished, we are finished with the topic. Okay, thank you, Beta. Thanks for the class.